We quickly learned these girls are not bad kids. They are dealing with a situation that is overwhelming. Tonight, we take a look at the lives of Valley teens who are now in a detention center. Since they are underage, we are hiding their faces.
These blank walls are filled with emotions.
I miss them so much, and I can't do nothing about it.
And horror stories.
And I had gotten to the point where I got in metal tube and I shattered the windows and I dented the hoods.
Sometimes I would steal, I would break into cars. And she was like screaming at me and she was like, you could have just asked me and everything. So I ended up pulling out a knife on her.
These girls share a common bond, breaking the law.
But the drugs had affected me in so many ways, like my skin color, me communicating with other people, trying to get along.
The Darrell Hester Juvenile Detention Center is where they are finding a path away from crime.
There's nothing compared to being in your own house, in your own bed.
The day begins early for these teenagers.
We wake up, we clean our rooms. We mop, we clean the toilet, the sink, and we clean the pot.
Daily chores are only a small portion of their day in this secure facility. Education is top priority while juvenile supervision officers keep a close eye on them.
Believe it or not, some of the girls say being here is better than living at home.
Despite the crimes they've committed, they are still children. When we asked them what was their favorite part of the week, they responded quickly.
Chicken Wednesday. It's not bad being here because they don't treat us bad.
There are many reasons why these girls end up here. Obtaining drugs from cartel members, minors, and prostitution are some of the examples. But what led them to this lifestyle? That's something only they can explain.
¿Cuándo comenzaste a hacer las drogas?
Desde los 11.
This 15-year-old grew up in a bad neighborhood where violence and drugs were commonplace. She claims her father was an alcoholic and used drugs.
Pase y tomar, pase y tomar, pase y tomar. Mis hermanos también.
Her brothers were in and out of jail.
Ahora entiendo que ellas no son amigas. La verdad, nunca fueron amigas, nunca.
She tells me she ran away more than 10 times. And there were many times she put herself in dangerous situations.
Era narcotraficante, la muchacha.
She even went as far as taking drugs from a woman who worked for the Gulf Cartel.
Era de El CDG.
And this girl, who at first did not want to participate in the group session, later approached us to share her story. It's not her first time at the detention center.
I had lost my temper with my father, and he assaulted me, but I started punching him.
A habitual runaway. She would eventually turn herself into police after it took them too long to find her, and she would get bored.
And I was still in this, I was like, real close from my house, and they never found me.
This young girl says she started using drugs when she was just 14 years old.
I was popping bars, bowls, rochas. I started smoking weed, joes, and I started smoking synthetic.
While most girls her age are trying to get through high school, this teen says she was trying to avoid abuse at the hand of her trusted family member.
And when I used to be with her, I was abused, and she just hit me out of the nowhere. And I used to hide in the bed, she used to drag me out of my hair.
She says after being in the detention center for the fifth time, one of the hardest parts is spending special occasions without her family.
Where would you have rather be for her birthday?
My home with my family.
Most of these girls, now labeled juvenile delinquents, are waiting to be released or are getting ready to go to a residential program like Ladies Inspired for Excellence. This residential program for women, which has been in operation for less than 3 years, is not like other living facilities. It has more room for personality.
We're also addressing the mental health need. We're addressing the trauma, some issues that they've are going through with their family. It's not just about the behavior and the crime. It's more underlying issues. So we wrap it around with a lot of counseling, a lot of activities.
Deputy Director Rose Gomez says running the program is hard work. It started as a non-secure program, but after some girls ran away, they had to change that.
We have to bring them back to detention, and for the most part, some of them do go back to life because they'll say, you know what, I shouldn't have done this. I want to go back to the program. And there's others that will say, you know, they're not at the point where they feel like they can change.
The problem is that the closest shelter to the valley is in Corpus Christi, but that soon may change.
Officials at the facility say these girls realize what they've done is wrong, and they do want to change. Tomorrow, we take a deeper look at the struggles these girls face, and we get an exclusive look at a new facility that is opening up in the valley that aims at helping these teens, especially those who run away. Tiffany Huerta, CBS 4 News and ValleyCentral.com.